back, learners. In this section, we are going to see the security of cyber-physical systems. What are cyber-physical systems? Cyber-physical systems integrate computational devices with physical systems to monitor and interact with them. Computational components are integrated to monitor, network, and control the overall process. I would like to quote the best definition coined in the year 2006 by Dr. Helen Gill. This is the most appropriate definition for cyber-physical systems. He defines cyber-physical system as any physical, biological, and engineered system operations that are integrated, monitored, and controlled by a computational core. I think this is the best one coined so far. Okay, CPS is an umbrella term consisting of a variety of control systems that connects the physical and the cyber world. Some of the applications of CPS include industrial control systems, ICS, such as supervisory control and data acquisition systems. In short, we call them as SCADA, distributed control systems, and programmable logic controllers. CPS is an interdisciplinary field. Since it is deployed as a computer-based systems in the physical world. For example, if you take the self-driven cars introduced by Google and Tesla, they are automated systems that work based on some algorithms integrated with the users and the internet. The physical components and the software components are deeply intertwined and they operate on different spatial and temporal scales. The presence of CPS in transportation, utilities, city services, and industry infrastructures focus on monitoring and controlling of vital systems to improve their efficiency. There are two primary components. They are the physical processes and the cyber system. A cyber system is a system of networks that comprises sensors, computers, and communicating devices. This system can control or monitor the physical processes that occur due to natural phenomena like volcanic eruption or due to a man-made physical system, something like a surgical room or completely a complex combination of both. The physical processes are vulnerable to security threats in cyber-physical systems. Cause, due to the interactions that take place between the physical systems and cyber systems, these vulnerabilities are a possibility. Cyber-physical system applications such as smart transportation system, medical systems, electronic power grids, are often prone to security vulnerabilities. A very important issue in these cyber-physical systems is to ensure secure interaction between the various systems. We'll see, before understanding the actual security requirements and vulnerabilities, we'll see the model of CPS. If you understand the model, it is easy for us to understand the risks. The model of CPS. The abstract model of CPS consists of three components, namely communication, computation and control, and the third one, monitoring and manipulation. The higher level and lower level components of CPS have the communication either wired or wireless with the real world. The intelligence, control commands, and receiving the sensed measures are the working strategy of the computation and control part. CPS is connected to the physical world and is manipulated through the monitoring and manipulation components. If you look at the general workflow of CPS, there are generally four steps involved in that. They are monitoring, networking, computing, and actuation. What is monitoring? This is the essential process of CPS that involves tracking of the physical system and its environment. Monitoring also involves operations of CPS during the past and making them to function properly in future by giving a feedback. Second one, networking. This step deals with the data aggregation and diffusion, because sensors are used to collect the data and they generate real-time data. There can be more than one sensor in the CPS, and so the generations of data sets are also larger. These data are to be classified or diffused for further operations and analysis. Third one, computing. This process involves computing of data obtained from the previous step, that is the monitoring step. It includes reasoning, analyzing, and verification of criteria based on which the physical processes function. If the processes do not follow the given criteria, then necessary steps and actions are taken to make it function properly to meet the requirements. For example, a model in CPS data center that is used to examine the temperature variations, it has algorithms present in it for scheduling and prediction of future operations. The last one is actuation. Actuation is used to initiate various actions to operate the CPS. These actions are determined for the computing phase. So, as mentioned earlier, CPS is also vulnerable to cyber attacks.